Elder Scrolls Blades Early Access. As I was early to sign up and validated my account for Elder Scrolls Blades, I gained access to the gameplay yesterday. As of now, I have 6 to 8 hours of gameplay behind me. It appears I kind of know how the gameplay works, and thus I'm able to review it. But before I begin, I'd like to remind you that this is an early access, and the issues, some of those issues, will be removed before the official launch. Well, is this game worthy of Elder Scrolls' name? No, absolutely not. It looks like Elder Scrolls, but it most definitely doesn't feel like one. I mean, putting Elder Scrolls on a mobile device, it sounds a bit sacrilege to me, but it ain't all bad. So the game begins with a short tutorial where you can learn the basics. There are two ways to move, aim and tap and slide to turn. Sometimes the game offers you to use on-screen joysticks, so you can use those as well, but I find it very clunky and distracting even, and I'm not even sure how they appear on my screen. Anyways, you make your way to the town or what's left of it. Your in-game mission is constantly to gather resources like lumber, limestone, copper, later even more stuff to rebuild and upgrade your town. Yeah, it becomes your town, you can even name it. You complete different quests by saving townsfolk from dungeons and defeating bandits, skeletons, goblins, spiders, rats, bears, and many other enemies. You collect skins, gold, resources, and blunder your way through the caves and catacombs. By using those resources to build up your town, you gain access to smithing and alchemy, and all the good stuff like salts, herbs, and other plants can be used. You also have skills. Those are divided into spells, perks, and abilities. You gain skill points by leveling up. As you do so, you have the option to enhance your magicka or stamina, the usual stuff. You basically have all the components of classical Elder Scrolls game, potions and crafting, but the one crucial part has always been the exploration, the feel of freedom as you adventure through the vast lands. In here, in Elder Scrolls Blades, it's been compiled into game sections of linearness. The most open part of the game is the town itself, as some dungeons tend to repeat quite often. The starting point may change, but the dungeon design stays the same. Locations have no overall map, so you like the feel of discovering new areas. They have no different names, no ways to give you a perspective of where you are located in the world. Just, you're teleported to random copy-paste dungeon again. The closest thing to variety is Abyss, a game mode which basically is a survivor mode. You make your way into deeper and deeper underground and face harder and harder enemies as you do so. There's also arena mode, but at the moment it's locked. I'm sure this will be a PvP area. And now my favorite part, what comes to the store, the microtransactions. You gain few daily rewards, but otherwise the game is highly monetized. Sadly, I can't say how much because it's still in early access. But what I know is that money buys you better weapons in this game, and this might hint pay-to-win mechanism. The premium currency of the game are gems. You gain very few as you play, but at least enough to start you off. With gems, you can upgrade your inventory space for gear or inventory space for chests. Now this is a bit obnoxious because you find a lot of chests in your travels, but opening silver and golden ones take 3 to 6 hours respectively. So my suggestion is to open all wooden ones first, as they take 5 seconds to open and it clears all your inventory space for new chests to be collected. Overall, it's a semi-fun game to play. Not sure if I can call it Elder Scrolls, but I really had fun playing it. Few quests got a bit hard, but changing your gear really makes a difference. As this early access stands, I have nothing bad to add. I have played a lot worse. But what comes to microtransactions? The prices vary between 3 to 104 euros, so it's a bit steep. As long as the game doesn't require me to spend real money, I can play and vouch for it. But if it's going to ask to finish this quest, you need this legendary epic warrior sword of the destiny, then I'm going to quit and make a very bad review. Now, I'm not going to rate the game because it still is in early access, but I will just put a smiling llama face in my thumbnail. I hope that you enjoyed this review, and if you did, hit that like, smash that bell, and if you dare, subscribe as well. I'm Sillyllamaz, and thanks for watching. Till next time.